Yes, students. So in PT2, there is chapter number 2, microorganism, friend and foe. Chapter number 4, materials, metals and non-metals. The next chapter number 3, conservation of plants and animals. Chapter number 13, sound. Chapter number 15, some natural phenomena. And next chapter number 18 is pollution of air and water. So students, there are 6 chapters in PT2. You all know that the syllabus of PT1 will be included in PT2. Okay, so you have to prepare the PT1 syllabus also along with the PT2. And next, you all know that the half yearly exams are of 80 marks. Clear? And the EVE topic is the study to study the effect of air pollution, how the pollution is affecting our environment. Okay, and the next, there are 4 activities in your syllabus. The first one is to study useful and harmful effects of microorganisms. Second one is that this activity we will discuss in the chapter number 2. Okay, and next is to study the effects of zinc and iron on copper sulfate solution. It is the activity of chapter number 4. And to study the vibrating bodies produced by produced sound. It is activity of chapter number 13. So, and the last one is to observe rain water harvesting system in school. Okay, so it is related to the chapter number 18. Yes, so students, we will discuss these activities along with the chapter. Clear? So before starting, today we will start the chapter number 2. And before starting, you must all know that you will start the PT2 syllabus. You just fold a paper and then start the PT2. Okay, you will also write the syllabus on the first page, on that page. Okay, then you will write the question answer or the another thing that we will provide you. And please open page number 17, chapter number 2, microorganisms, friend and foe. You must have a pencil with you so that you can underline the important things. So we are starting the chapter microorganisms, friend and foe. Okay. Good morning, Aditi ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, Imani ma'am.
Shall I make you host? So the chapter name is Microorganism, Friend and Foe. So microorganism, the discovery of the microscope revealed a new world, that is the world of the microorganisms. Okay, so what are microorganisms? These are the tiny particles that we can't see with naked eye. Okay, so we require microscope to see these microorganisms. Okay, so what are these? These are the tiny particles and can be seen with the microscope. We can't see it with the naked eye because these are very small in size. Yep. We are starting I am reading the first para. You have seen several kind of plants and animals. However, there are other living organisms around us which we cannot see. These are called microorganisms or microbes. These are also called microbes. Okay, you can underline. So these microorganisms are all around us. Okay, either we cannot see them, but these are present all around us. For example, you have just observed that during the rainy season, the moist bread gets spoiled. Okay, there are some patches that are there that are grayish white patches that we can observe. So, for example, you might have observed that during the rainy season, moist bread gets spoiled and its surface gets covered with grayish white patches. So these white patches are visible to us. Okay, so these are patches that are grown over it. These can be seen with the help of magnifying glass also. You can see its structure. Okay, so what type of microorganism there is in the moist bread which gets spoiled? It is fungi. Okay, it is the only that we can see with our eyes. Okay, other microorganism we can't see them. Okay, because that are very small. We need microscope to see the microorganisms. Yeah. So next, the first topics to 2.1. There is an activity 2.1. I will share a video. Okay. Yes, students. So these microorganisms are very small. Okay, for seeing them we require microscope. And in the activity 2.1, what will we do? We will test the soil, either the microorganisms are present in the soil also or not. Okay, so the activity 2.1, collect some moist soil from the field in a beaker. So what we will do, we will take the moist soil and we will take two beakers, okay? And then we add that soil into water. Yeah? For this, we need, what are the material that we require? Beaker, soil, dropper, cover slip, and glass slide. Okay, also the microscope to see the tiny organisms. Okay, in the activity we will add soil in beaker and then we will add water to it. Yeah, and then next we will mix it. Okay, and we will keep it on a side, okay, so that no one can disturb it. And then we will take a little sample from it with the help of a dropper and then put it on the glass slide. Okay, and the next is that you will cover this sample with the cover slip. It is cover slip. Okay, it is very thin. We will cover the sample with this cover slip. Clear? And then we will observe this glass slide under the microscope. Clear? You have to handle it carefully. Next, we will observe this under the microscope. Clear? You can see these type of microorganisms are there. Okay, students, the picture that is also shown in your book on page number 918. As we are in the COVID situation, we are not present in the school. The all students are not in the school, so we are taking the classes virtually. So otherwise, we can perform this activity also in the lab. We can see the microorganisms. The pictures that is taken by the microscope are shown in the on the page number 18. Okay. Now next is, so you what is the conclusion from this activity? That the microorganisms are even present in the soil. Clear? And the next is activity number 2.2. It is same as that we have done in 2.1, but just we have to take the, in that we have taken soil and mixed it with water. But now in the activity 2.2, we will take the few drops of water from the pond. Okay, and then we will again observe it carefully under the microscope. Clear? So you are seeing this, it is even present in water, soil, it is also present in air. Clear? And coming to the next para, these observations show that water and soil are full of tiny organisms. Though not all of them fall into the category of microbes, these microorganisms or microbes are also small in size that they cannot be seen with the unaided eye. Some of these, I have talked about fungus. Okay, or fungi that is growing on the bread, it can be seen with our eyes. There is no need, or we can also use magnifying glass, but there is no need to see fungi with the help of, we can also see it with our eyes. Okay, there is no need of a microscope. We can, kyunki ye hame aise dikhai de rahe hain. Okay. And next, coming to the classification of microorganisms. So these are categorized, microorganisms are categorized into four main categories. The first one is bacteria. And then next is fungi, protozoa. And fourth one is algae. There is another, there is viruses also, but I am writing it below them in a differentiated category. We will discuss the virus later on. Okay. It is also important, but it does not come in the four major categories because it is something is different in these viruses. Okay, that make them make viruses different from all the above. Here, one by one we will discuss. First is bacteria. So bacteria is all around us. It is present in air, soil, hot springs, even these bacteria are very tiny. Okay, these are present even in cold regions or the where the temperature is very low. Clear? So these are also present in humans and animals. In the living organism, there are some bacteria that are present. So during the rain, agar jab barish bahut time baad ho, jaise ki now summers are going on, jaise ki kal barish thi hui thi. तो क्या है उसमें जो एक जो सॉइल है उसमें से एक पर्टिकुलर स्मेल आती है. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो ड्यू टू अ बैक्टीरिया. एनीवन नो अबाउट इट? व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया? So it is your homework. You will find out the smell, the beautiful smell of rain is due to which type, which bacteria. Okay, note it down on your notebook. So the bacteria, the growth of the bacteria requires the moisture and warm. मॉइस्चर चाहिए और उसको जो टेम्परेचर है वॉर्म की कुकिंग क्या है वार्म चाहिए ठीक है. देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ बैक्टीरिया दैट आर गिवन. यू कैन आल्सो सी द पेज नंबर 18 द टू फिगर 2.1. देयर आर टू बैक्टीरिया दैट आर गिवन स्पाइरल बैक्टीरिया एंड अ रॉड शेप्ड बैक्टीरिया. सो दीज स्पाइरल बैक्टीरिया एंड रॉड शेप्ड बैक्टीरिया the name is due to the shape they possess. Uski spiral shape hai isliye usko spiral bacteria bolte hain. And the other one is rod shaped, therefore it is called the rod shaped bacteria. Clear? So these bacteria will also cause some diseases. For example, bacteria causes TB. It is tuberculosis or typhoid. And typhoid we will discuss in detail. Okay, about the what are the diseases that are caused by bacteria, we will study in detail in the chapter. Next we will move toward the next category, that is fungi. So fungi, we can see this on the bread. Okay, fungi can be unicellular. Unicellular, what is the meaning of unicellular? There are two types of cellular organisms, unicellular and multicellular. Unicellular. It is clear from
excuse me, Mani ma'am.
Me means single. Me means single. And multicellular means that means there are many types, many cells that are present. Therefore, the organisms are called multicellular or unicellular. Okay, clear? We have discussed the bacteria. It is important to note that it is single cell. Bacteria is single cell. Note it down on your notebook that bacteria is single cell and fungi can be unicellular or multicellular. Okay? It is unicellular also and multicellular also. It depends upon the type of the fungi that is there. Okay? And the next is जब जो ब्रेड है मॉइस्ट हो गई है उसको हमने अच्छे तरह से स्टोर नहीं किया है तब उसमें फंगी लगेगी. ओके एंड इट इज हार्मफुल टू ईट दैट ब्रेड ऑल्सो बिकॉज इट कैन कॉज पॉइजनिंग. फूड पॉइजनिंग भी हो सकती है इसलिए हमें अवॉइड ही करना चाहिए एंड वी शुड स्टोर दैट ब्रेड ऑन अ प्रॉपर प्लेस. ओके आपने देखा होगा कि कुछ कभी अगर वो टेम्परेचर वो आप ड्राई क्लोथ्स प्रॉपरली नहीं है तो उस पर भी कभी कभी पाउडरी सा सब्सटेंस लग जाता है. अगर आप अलमीरा में उनको प्रॉपरली ड्राई नहीं हुए हैं, सन ड्राई नहीं हुए हैं, अगर आप उनको भी रख दोगे तो ड्यू टू द मॉइस्चर उसमें भी जो है फंगी लग सकती है. क्लियर? Yes, students. Next example of fungi is I have given the example of bread also, and there is another fungi also that we eat, mushroom. So mushroom क्या है? ये multicellular है, इसलिए हमें we can see it, okay, or we can also eat it. It is not harmful. Okay, there are some microorganisms that are harmful. Okay, that we will study. Therefore, the chapter name as chapter is friend and foe microorganisms. It can these are friends also and these are our enemy also. Okay, so mushroom, it is multicellular fungi. Okay, and we can see it. There are some other fungi also that are dangerous for us and that are not edible. Mushroom हम इसको खाते हैं, ठीक है? And next is protozoa. Next thing that we will discuss is protozoa. Just 1 minute. You just see the page number 18. 2.4 fungi. Bread mold is given, and next is the penicillin, and next is aspergillus. So there is another important point about the fungi also, that it is the penicillium is used in the it is the first antibiotic. Just write it down on your notebook, sorry, textbook. Next is protozoa. So protozoa are also unicellular. You can write it. You will write the unicellular. Okay, I'm just writing it here. So protozoa are also Now the third type, it is unicellular in nature. Now there are some harmful effects of protozoa also. Here, for example, in the book, amoeba and paramecium are given. In the figure number 2.3, amoeba, we have discussed about the reproduction in amoeba and the digestion in amoeba in the previous class also. How it is taking food, how it is reproducing. So we have discussed. So the protozoa will cause diseases. Okay, for example, dysentery. Note it down. Just underline in your notebook. On page number 17, it is given in the last para. Last second para, diseases like dysentery and malaria are caused by protozoa, while typhoid and TB, tuberculosis, are the bacterial diseases. Here, virus we will discuss it later on. And next is algae. Algae to bahut commonly jo hai hame dikhai deti hai. For example, jahan pe stagnant water hai. जहां पे लेक है, पॉन्ड है, ठीक है, यू कैन सी दैट जो पॉन्ड है वो ग्रीन कलर से पैचेस से कवर हुआ होता है. क्लियर? सो इट इज इजली अवेलेबल एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो सी इट. एंड एल्गी कैन बी यूनिसेलुलर और मल्टी सेलुलर. It can be unicellular or multicellular. The term is clear to you. Uni means single cell. Multi means there are more than one. Clear? So, there is a algae named phytoplankton. That you see on the stagnant water, जो आपको visible होती है, phytoplankton. Okay, so these are the floating microorganisms. Okay, you can easily see them, and they also do photosynthesis. That means they prepare their own food. Next is, if we want to, we are able to see that algae, and we can also observe it under microscope to get the clear image of the organism that are present in it. वो तो हमें सिर्फ ग्रीन कलर की दिखेगी. और व्हाट वी कैन डू टू ऑब्जर्व इट, हमें जो थोड़ा सा जो उसका सैंपल है हम वो कलेक्ट करेंगे. सिमिलरली दैट वी हैव डन फॉर द सॉइल, देन वी विल डू फॉर द उसका जो एल्गी का पैच होगा जो हमने उसको रिमूव किया होगा, देन वी विल सी इट अंडर माइक्रोस्कोप. ओके, एंड द माइक्रोस्कोप विल गिव द एनलार्ज इमेज एंड दैट ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर क्लियरली विजिबल. वो तो हमें सिर्फ ग्रीन कलर का पैच दिखेगा जब हम अपनी आई से ऐसे देखें, पर माइक्रोस्कोप क्या उसकी जो इमेज है वो बिल्कुल क्लियर हमें दे देगा. यस अमन कालिया, इट इज राइट. यू हैव रिटन द नेम ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया दैट कॉजेज द स्मेल ऑफ रेन, बट आई विल आस्क द अदर स्टूडेंट्स टुमारो. नाउ if there is any doubt you can ask. Yes Yash, with
protozoa mein dengue bhi aa sakta hai.
Can you repeat it bache?
Mam protozoa mein dengue bhi aa sakta hai.
Kisme?
Protozoa mein
kya aa sakte hain? What you are telling?
Dengue.
Dengue is a disease that is caused by virus. Okay, that we will discuss. Okay, yes. So now we will come to the viruses. Okay, so these viruses, now you are all familiar with the name due to the coronavirus. So viruses are even more tinier than these organisms. These are also tinier. But that are more tinier or the viruses are tiniest from all of them. I will discuss the virus. Show a thumbs up. I hope you have noted it down. Okay. So next we will move to the viruses. Actually, these lies between the bottom line of the living and non-living. जब तक ये किसी surface पे है ऐसे ही है, जैसे कि आपको पता है कि जब अगर यहाँ पे कोई सरफेस पे वायरस है सो इट इज नॉन लिविंग, इट इज नॉट कॉजिंग एनी हार्म टू मी. ओके, बट व्हेन इट एंटर्स टू अ लिविंग बॉडी आइदर प्लांट और एनी एनिमल और एनी ह्यूमन देन इट विल कॉज हार्म. ओके, एंड इन दैट केस दे बिकम लिविंग. जब तक वो किसी सर्फेस पे है वो नॉन लिविंग है, बट जब ही वो किसी होस्ट में एंटर करेंगे दे विल बिकम लिविंग. सो कमिंग टू द पैरा, थर्ड पैरा, कॉलम नंबर टू, पेज नंबर द फर्स्ट पेज सॉरी द पेज नंबर 17. वायरसेस आर माइक्रोस्कोपिक. सो द माइक्रोस्कोप वायरसेस आर ऑल्सो माइक्रोस्कोपिक. That means you need microscope, but these are not visible by the compound microscope. So we require electron microscopes to see it because these are very very tiny. Yeah, ये हमारे जो simple compound microscope है उसको visible नहीं होंगे. ठीक है, and these are therefore इसकी जो treatment है, क्योंकि इसलिए इसमें वैक्सीन के लिए इतना टाइम लगा है क्योंकि कोरोना वायरस एट कोविड इज आल्सो, इट इज आल्सो एन एग्जांपल ऑफ वायरस. क्लियर? सो आई एम रीडिंग द पैरा. वायरसेस आर आल्सो माइक्रोस्कोपिक, दे however reproduce only inside the cell of the microorganism, which may be bacterium, plant or animal. Some of the viruses that the viruses jo cause karte hain wo disease kya hai, it will cause polio, it is due to polio virus. Okay, and next is the chicken pox, it is also caused by virus. Clear? So these are put in a separate category. Okay, not in the major categorization of the microorganisms. Clear? These are the you can see its diagram on figure 2.5. There is the first one is adenovirus, and next is bacteriophage. You can write its name. The figure first one is of adenovirus. Yep. And next one is bacteriophage. Now, students, I am pasting Google form. Please mark your attendance. So students, you will revise the chapter up to this part. Okay, we have done the page number 17, 18. We have not started the topic 2.2. Okay, so before topic 2.2 that we have discussed,